Death is a certainty for all human beings walking the planet. No matter your race, creed, religion or gender, the only guarantee in life is indeed death. How long will I live? This is a question many people ask at some stage in their lives. How many years do I have? When will I die? To answer this question, there are considerable variations that need to be taken into account. Most importantly, your geographic location. Unfortunately, modern life expectancy is determined by where you live, the country you reside in. Countries in the Western sphere of the world dominate the list of countries with the highest life expectancy, whilst African nations constitute the bottom 35 countries with the lowest life expectancy. Not a single African nation appears in the list of the top 80 countries with the highest life expectancy. Not a single one. Let's be honest. Are we really surprised? For many of us, the answer is no. We've all accepted this dichotomy as normal. We've all subscribed to the notion that all men are created equal, however, some more equal than others. We know this because if you happen to be born in Africa, you dream of leaving Africa to pursue a better life in the Western world. However, if you're lucky enough to be born in the Western world, you only dream of seeing the wildlife in Africa and swiftly returning home, but never to stay. Africa has turned into a death trap for many of its people. In this podcast, I'm going to talk about Zimbabwe's death trap and the three ways to die in Zimbabwe. The objective of this podcast is not to make you afraid of visiting or living in Zimbabwe, not at all. Rather, the objective of this podcast is to make the world aware of the plight of many Zimbabweans living in extremely difficult circumstances. In no particular order, the number one of the three ways to die in Zimbabwe: road accidents. If you've been in Zimbabwe or live in Zimbabwe, you know the roads are treacherous. The main routes connecting major cities like Harare, Bulawayo, and Victoria Falls are in decent condition. However, you really need to pay close attention to the potholes, of which there are a number. Indeed, attempts have been made to address the issue of potholes in Zimbabwe. However, the government has fallen short of fully rectifying those issues. Potholes are one of the leading contributors of road deaths in Zimbabwe, along with driver incompetence, more specifically drink driving. Zimbabwe is in the grips of a drink driving pandemic. It's rampant and something needs to be done. Indeed, the government has a role to play. However, more importantly, we as the citizens of Zimbabwe have to take responsibility for our actions and put an end to the drink driving pandemic in Zimbabwe. Currently, road deaths in Zimbabwe stand at approximately 10 to 12,000 per year, according to the United Nations, and that number is expected to triple in the next 10 years. Number two of the three ways to die in Zimbabwe: in hospital. Hospitals in Zimbabwe are extremely underfunded, under-equipped, and understaffed. Many people in Zimbabwe needlessly die because of easily treatable ailments in hospitals across the country. Every Zimbabwean has a story of a friend or a relative who passed away whilst waiting for treatment in hospital. Cancer patients go without treatment, and people who suffer from acute renal failure go without dialysis. A trip to the hospital can quickly turn into a nightmare, and for many, one you never wake from. Thousands of people die needlessly whilst waiting for treatment in many of Zimbabwe's hospitals. Some staggering numbers. Finally, number three of the three ways to die in Zimbabwe: poverty. According to the World Health Organization, approximately 4 million Zimbabweans are facing insufficient food consumption in 2023, Statistics have shown that 1 in 3 Zimbabwean children suffer from malnutrition. The rising cost of living in Zimbabwe is pushing more families into the clutches of poverty and food insecurity. We've all heard the stories of families who survive on one meal a day. It's quite normal in Zimbabwe. It's staggering to believe that in 2023, 25% of children born in Zimbabwe die of malnutrition. This is the reality of life in Zimbabwe. These are the challenges Zimbabwe is faced with. It comes as no surprise that the average life expectancy is 58 compared to 81 in the UK. Some shocking figures. You may be led to believe that this is simply the result of bad governance and corruption, or perhaps greedy African leaders. However, corruption and bad governance is not unique to Africa, let alone Zimbabwe. Granted, corruption is a disease which needs to be rooted out in Zimbabwe. However, let's look at the facts. The reality is that Zimbabwe has been under severe sanctions for the last 20 years. These economic sanctions caused the collapse of the Zim dollar and continue to sabotage the recovery of the Zimbabwean economy. Zimbabwe has since adopted the US dollar as legal tender, and 75% of transactions are completed in US dollars. The issue is that the Zimbabwean government has no control over the amount of US dollars circulating the economy. In reality, Zimbabwe has too little in terms of US dollar liquidity to make the economy function properly and deliver crucial services to the people of Zimbabwe. The equipment and materials needed to repair Zimbabwe's roads require US dollars. The equipment and medicines urgently needed in hospitals also require US dollars. The monies required for food imports and subsidies, you guessed it, also require US dollars. So here's the big question. Where does the government get this foreign currency from? Well, they certainly can't print it, and they can't exchange Zim dollars that we can print for hard foreign currency outside of Zimbabwe. You'd hope that the government can raise this money through tax collection. However, it's not quite that simple. How do you tax cash? 70% of Zimbabweans are working in the informal sector, and the government is missing out on approximately $42 billion of taxable revenues every year. Let's be real. When was the last time you paid tax? How do you tax the market trader selling produce for cash? How do you tax the mechanic fixing cars for cash? It's an impossible task. So before you start complaining, understand this. Governments need to collect taxes in order to provide public services. Most Zimbabweans don't pay income taxes, plain and simple. I think the time has come for us as a people to face the ugly truth. Sanctions have destroyed Zimbabwe and continue to do so. The reality is that there's a measurable human cost to economic sanctions. At the core of all the challenges Zimbabwe is facing are sanctions. Inflation is at an all-time high because of sanctions. Dollarization and the contraction of the Zimbabwean economy is a direct result of sanctions. Roads are in disrepair because of sanctions. Hospitals are defunct because of sanctions. Doctors and nurses are leaving Zimbabwe because of sanctions. Millions of Zimbabweans are living in poverty and facing malnutrition because of sanctions. Over the last 20 years, sanctions have caused the death of hundreds of thousands of Zimbabweans directly and indirectly. For every Zimbabwean doctor, nurse, or care worker. In the UK, Australia, or the United States, there are hundreds of patients going without care in Zimbabwean hospitals every day. People are dying as a result of this, and it is indeed a crime against humanity. This is the human cost of economic sanctions against Zimbabwe. Like I said at the beginning of this podcast, all humans are created equal, however some clearly more equal than others. Economic sanctions are a crime against humanity. Throughout history, we have all witnessed how sanctions have been disproportionately targeted against African nations, and I think it's time that we call a spade a spade. Economic sanctions are designed to cripple economies, and it's been proven time after time that there's a human cost to these sanctions. The same way we recognize that nuclear weapons are devastating for humanity, we also need to recognize that economic sanctions are equally devastating for human life.